it's really important to find something that you love and that you're passionate about. And bikes probably for all of us have done that, but I think when you compare that with some trail work periodically throughout the year and meaningful trail work, I think it's just an amazing pairing. And once you tap into that volunteer community, it's just a really cool network of people to be able to hang out with, and they're out there volunteering their time to improve all of our rides. So I think the community element of this whole thing is really, really what it boils down to, that human connection for us. My name's Nick Gibson. I'm the race director for Trans-Cascadia. Yeah, our mission is to restore and maintain backcountry trails in the Pacific Northwest and build community. We found a little niche between all the user groups out there and all the great organizations doing work. There's this swath of land deep in the woods that just doesn't get as much maintenance as you'd like. And so we're out here maintaining it and keeping it open.
Doing this kind of trail work is super important because it really connects the communities, especially the ones that are utilizing these trail networks, and it can help with their progression and their ability to connect with the land and the communities. So it's super important to give back in that way, and it's super rewarding as well. Like building more trails for folks to ride, it helps you make connections with people that you wouldn't otherwise get to connect with, and it's just so fun and so rewarding.
There's many challenges with backcountry trail building. Number one is getting into the work site with enough equipment to create some meaningful work and show some improvement. Bicycles are definitely a must.
Generally, we're carrying like a 30 to 50 pound pack with fuel and a saw or fuel and a tool of some kind. And so sometimes you're riding 2-3 hours to get to your work spot, and then you're working a full day, and then you're packing up and riding out. We've been working with Dakine and the Builder Pack since this event began, and it really, you just can't do the work without it.
It's an enabler. It allows us to carry as much as we want in the backcountry, sometimes maybe more than we thought we needed back there.
It's my preferred way for carrying big tools, chainsaw, making sure you have all the necessities when you're out in the woods.
We basically get to kind of outfit our entire trail community with these things. For us, this is an essential tool. You know, you're only as good as what you can carry, and this allows us to really get a bunch of gear to the top of the mountain.
It's designed with mountain bikers in mind, so it's awesome to be able to put all your tools in the bag and still get to ride down and shred the stuff that you spent all day working on.
Shred preservation is an important thing that we need to start to get out, right? Like, the Trail Boss tool, the Dakine Builder Pack, these are things that allow you to ride your bike hard at the end of your day, or even when you're still riding. Like, you're riding your bike, it's heavy, but it does allow you to still enjoy your ride.
Yeah, doing the hard work on the trails is gratifying. You know, we definitely bring attention to the trail systems that we work on. Hopefully that attention and increased ridership creates more stewards and just gives an appreciation for the trails as they are, and those improvements hopefully feed the community and, you know, stoke people out.